We've got a good crowd filing in here at Yankee Stadium. Starting pitches boosting up down below us. Jerry Arrigo, the young left-hander for Minnesota, and Jim Bouton, a right-hander for the Yankees. Here are the starting lineup. For the Twins, leading off and playing shortstop, Zerlo Versailles. Rich Rollins at third base, batting second. Hitting in the third position in right field, Tony Oliva. Armin Killebrew will be batting cleanup and playing left field. In center field, batting fifth, Bob Allison. Don Mincher will be playing first base, batting sixth. Doing the catching and batting seventh, Earl Batty. Jim Snyder will be hitting eighth and playing second base. And doing the pitching and batting ninth, Jerry Arrigo. For the Yankees, Phil Lynch leads off playing third base. At second base, Bobby Richardson batting second. Hector Lopez will be in left field hitting third. Hitting in the cleanup spot in center field, Mickey Mantle. Elston Howard will be doing the catching and batting fifth. At first base, batting sixth, Joe Pepitone. Cleve Boyer, the shortstop, batting seventh. In right field, hitting eighth, Pedro Gonzalez. Roger Maris, who fouled that ball just above his ankle and had to leave the ball game, has gone home to Kansas City. Will not be able to play tomorrow, and then has three off days for the All-Star break. So Roger will go home and recuperate. And during the pitching and batting ninth will be Jim Bouton. The umpire is coming out of the Yankee dugout now, led by Bill Valentine, will be calling balls and strikes. At first base will be Larry Knapp, Johnny Stevens at second, and Hank Soar at third. Yogi Berra coming out with Hank Soar, having a little chat, and Sam Milley, the manager of the Minnesota Twins, who has done a real fine job ever since getting the reins over for Minnesota, comes up with the lineup cards, and they'll be exchanging lineup cards and going over the ground rules. And while they are, we'll give you a look at some of the late scores last night. The Dodgers defeated the Mets 6-2. The Phillies beat the Giants 5-1. Pittsburgh defeated Houston 2-1. Cincinnati took the Cardinals 4-1. And Milwaukee beat the Cubs 8-2. In the American League, as you know, the Twins defeated the Yankees 1-0 in 10 innings. Washington defeated Detroit 3-1 in the first game in 12 innings. And in the second game, it was Detroit 2 and Washington 1. Baltimore defeated Kansas City 4-0 as the young 19-year-old right-hander Wally Bunker pitched a one-hitter, shutting out Kansas City. The Angels defeated the Red Sox 5-3 in 10 innings, and Cleveland beat the White Sox 2-1 in 11 innings. A lot of extra-inning ball games in both leagues last night. Well, they break up the huddle at home plate. And we're waiting now for the Yankees to take the field. And it looks like a good day for a doubleheader. Though the sun is not shining, it is not near as warm or humid as it has been in the past week. And there are still plenty of good seats available for you fans who are out driving and might not enjoy the beach on an overcast day such as this, but it's perfect for a baseball game. Still got plenty of good seats left. And a lot of action with the Homer Happy Twins here and the New York Yankees, who have been playing exciting baseball. And there go the Yankees out on the field. Walking out to the mound is a blip. Just goes over the center of Yankee Stadium. A small blip. Mountain has won 6, lost 7 this year. Against the Twins, he's 1 and lost 1. But lifetime against Minnesota, he is 1-4 and lost 1. It will be Bowden's 17th appearance, all starting assignments. His third against the Twins. Faced him last on June the 2nd at Minnesota. He was a losing pitcher, allowing 3 runs. 2 of them earned in 3 innings. Bowden will take his warm-up tosses. Jim is 6 feet tall, 185 pounds, born in Newark, New Jersey, now living in Ridgewood, New Jersey. Size, right hand hitting shortstop for the Twins. Swinging the bat alongside home plate, watching Jim Bowden loosen up. On deck will be Rich Rollins, to be followed by Tony Oliva. Mantle throwing the ball in the outfield along with Hector Lopez, getting loosened up. Coaching at third for the Twins is Floyd Baker. First base, Ed Fitzgerald, and they want the lights on here at Yankee Stadium. Played on fire, Bill Valentine has just signaled for the lights to be turned on. As we told you, it is quite overcast, but very, very comfortable. And today, the wind has shifted and is blowing out towards right field. In last night's ball game, it was blowing out to left field, though no one was able to take advantage of the wind. A 1-0 game in 10 innings. Everybody was looking for a lot of extra bases and a lot of home runs. But the pitchers surprised everybody. Dick Sigmund and Stan Williams. Each pitched beautiful ball. Williams went 9 innings, giving up just 2 hits and no runs. And the lights are being turned on, and it's a beautiful sight. It makes it look like the sun is shining on Yankee Stadium. All right, Bob is ready. Howard fires the ball down to second base. Versailles steps into the batter's box as Bill Valentine dusts off home plate. Step back to get a little fine tar and rosin on the handle of his bat. And the Yankees and the Twins meeting for the 8th time this year. The Twins have won 5. The Yankees have won just 2. Royal batting 268, has 14 doubles, 8 triples, 8 homers, 29 runs batted in, 7 stolen bases. The first pitch of the ball game is blown outside, ball 1. Friends playing even with the bag for the speedy Versailles. Rest of the infield shortens up a couple of steps. He can fly down that line. About the next pitch is pop foul back in the upper deck out of play. 1-1 to count. Outfield plays Zoilo straight away. Matter of fact, they give him a lot of the right field line as Gonzalez now moves over a little bit to right center. Curve check, swing foul back in the crowd. 1-2. And the second game today, it'll be Camilo Pascual, the curveball king, against Al Downing, the Yankees southpaw. And tomorrow it'll be Whitey Ford against Jim Mudcat Grant. Change of pace foul back on the screen just below it. Out holds at 1-2. Strange thing, this is the only doubleheader scheduled in either league. The pitch is line to right field. Gonzalez coming on, can't get it. Has to play it on one hop. A line drive single to right field for Doyle over Salas. likes his name pronounced Versailles. But every once in a while, I'll slip and call him Versailles. Rich Rollins, the batter. Rollins batting 268, has 16 doubles, 4 triples, 8 homers, and 43 runs batted in. No one out here in the top of the first inning in this first game for doubleheader. Stretch by Bowden. Pitch is low. Picked up nicely in the dirt by Howard. Ball one. Rollins had bluffed a bunt, and Lynch came charging in from third base. On deck is Tony Oliva. Against Versailles, who now has the time, goes over to talk with Ed Fitzgerald, the first base coach. Checking either Rollins' hit and run signal or the steal sign. Every batter has a different hit and run sign. Here's the stretch. The pitch, another bluff bunt, it's outside. Two balls, no strike. And there is one play when the whole infield is in motion on a bunt situation. Third baseman comes in. The shortstop moves over to second. The second baseman goes over to cover first. The first baseman comes charging in, and the pitcher bounces off the mound, either right or left. Two balls, no strikes. It's the perfect time for the hit and run. Here's the stretch. He's going. The ball is fouled out of play. They had the hit and run on. The reason I say it's a perfect spot, the pitcher has to be around the plate or risk the chance of getting a 3-0 count on a batter. No spot, definitely, for a pitch out. Two balls, one strike on Rich Rollins. Versailles really had a big lead at first base that time. Five bounce stretches. The run is going. The ball is swung at and missed. The throw to second base. Not in time. Perfect throw to second, but Zorlo slid in there under Richardson's tag. Stolen base for Versailles, and that's his eighth stolen base of the year, the second in this series. He stole one last night. A 2-2 count on Rich Rollins. Now Bowden set. And Rollins asked the time, and Bob, ready to deliver, had a hold on as he took his stride and almost fell down on the mound. Quite a shock for a pitcher, ready to pitch and throw hard, and suddenly see the umpire jump out from the back of the catcher with his hands up. You could possibly hurt your arm doing that, holding back on a pitch. Of course, Bowden could have thrown the ball, and it wouldn't have counted. Two balls, two strikes. Here's the stretch. Big lead by Versailles. They get him back now. The curve in the dirt, 3-2. Zorlo had ideas that time, but Richardson bluffed him back. And as Zorlo started back to second, Bowden delivered the pitch. So it's a full count. Here's the stretch. Payoff pitch, strike three, swinging. He hit him with a high fastball. First strikeout for Bowden, and a big one. That brings up Tony Oliva. Oliva batting 333, has 17 doubles, 5 triples, 17 homers, and 48 runs batted in. He also has 4 stolen bases. A left-hand batter. Strike right down the middle. He's 6'1", 175 pounds. Now lives in St. Petersburg, Florida. And now as we read, we find out that he is known as Tony because he used his brother's passport to get into this country from Cuba. 1941. Loudon sits. Curve is on the inside corner, strike two. And Oliva was falling back out of the way of that pitch, thinking it was inside. Nothing in two. On deck is Harmon Killebrew. Second base. Stretch by Bowden. Fastball high and outside. One ball, two strikes. No score. We're on the top of the first inning. Jim Bowden gets the sign from Elston Howard. And then Oliva steps out as Bob took a little too long reading Howard's sign. Left-hand hitter gets back in the box. Pulls the bat right down on the end and crouches at the plate. Now Bob is ready. Fastball, line is center field, base hit. Here comes the size around third. He'll score easily in the Twins lead, 1-0. Batted in for Tony Oliva. The second hit off Bob. That brings up Harmon Killebrew, leading the Major League in home runs with 28. He's batting .277, has 60 runs batted in, also has four doubles. Curve to Killebrew, high and outside, ball one. Players now that they've been up so many times on a base hit do not jump too high. For instance, Oliva started the game at 333. With that base hit, he went up just 2 points to 335. And by the same token, you don't drop too much when you don't get base hit. One out. Oliva at first. One ball, no strike on Harmon Killebrew. And that was 109th hit for Oliva. There's a fastball low and inside. Two balls, no strike. Oliva with a short lead off first base. Bowden ready for the 2-0 pitch to Killebrew. Swing, a ground ball, take it. Have runners at first and third with one out. Now Killebrew hits that ball with overspin, the way Ted Williams used to hit it. And though that ball was only about 5 feet to Boyer's left, Boyer did not have a chance to get it. When you hit a ball with overspin, it picks up speed as it hits the ground. The reason that Killebrew and Williams hit the ball with overspin, they swing at the ball with sort of an uppercut swing. They do not have a level swing. Pretty tough to hit the ball that way, swinging up at the ball. But they did it. I remember Ted Williams, and we used to overshift on him, and he'd hit some of those overspin grounders. They could hit right in the middle of your glove and spin right out. Bob Allison up. Takes a curve low and outside, ball one. Allison, leading the American League in batting with a .340 average, has 22 doubles, two triples, 21 homers, and 53 runs batted in. Third, Killebrew at first with one out. The pitch to Allison, low and outside, ball two, 2-0. The Twins leading 1-0. We're on the top of the first inning. On deck is Don Mincher. Here's the stretch by Bowden. Fastball, Pop Sauber coming back out of play and back of home plate in the upper deck. And then kicked down below as the fan lost it. Two balls, one strike on Big Bob Allison. double play depth. Fouls are set. High pop up. That 3-4 is under. That shortstop just on the edge of the outfield grass makes it. The grab will leave a bluff tagging up and coming home, but with Boyer's arm, he respects it. Just trying to draw a throw. Here is John Mincher. Mincher batting 311. Four doubles, two triples, 10 homers, and 30 runs batted in. Last night, Mincher, in the top of the 10th, hit Ralph Terry's first pitch about 450 feet. One bounce off the center field wall. Got a triple. And put a pinch runner in for him. Jerry Kindle scored on a sacrifice fly by Jim Snyder. Pitch to the left-hand hitter is a curve on the inside corner. Strike one call. Mincher is 6'3 and 205 pounds. Runners lead away. Change of pace is low. One and one. We told you last night, old Eagle Eye Joe Cooper spotted the whole Minnesota Twins infield wearing glasses. First baseman, second baseman, third baseman, and shortstop all wear specs. Pitch is a curve, high and tight. Two balls and a strike. Oliva off there. Pitch to Mincher. High pump up to the right side. Bobby Richardson is under this one. On the outfield grass, pounding the glove and making the catch for the third out. So the Yankees get out of that kind of lucky for the Twins. One run on three base hits. No Yankee errors. Two men left, and at the end of one half inning, it's the Twins one and the Yankees nothing.
Gives you easygoing taste, honest enjoyment, choice quality tobaccos. The exclusive Camel blend of costly tobaccos has never been equaled. The best tobacco makes the best smoke.
Right now makes it Camel time. Have a Camel cigarette. Right now makes it Camel time.
The left-hander on the mound for the Twins has won six and lost one this year. Against the Yankees this year, he's won one and lost none. Lifetime against New York, one win, one defeat. This is his 23rd appearance of the year, his seventh starting assignment, second against the Yankees. Beat them 6-2 on June the 2nd in Minnesota, pitching a complete game. Arrigo is 6'1", 180 pounds, born in Chicago, Illinois. Bill Lynn's leading off. Batting 234, 11 doubles, 1 triple, 3 homers, and 11 runs batted in. Pitch to Lins is a strike ball. In Arrigo's last start on June the 30th at Baltimore, he was the winning pitcher, allowed one run in 7 and 2/3 innings. Batting 250, has 11 doubles, 3 triples, 2 homers, and 22 runs batted in. Arrigo pitched a one-hit shutout against the Chicago White Sox on June the 26th. A bluff bunt attempt taken high and inside, ball one. On deck, Hector Lopez. The Twins one and the Yankees nothing here in the bottom of the first. just 23 years old, born June the 12th, 1941. First base. Pitch to Richardson. High ball three. He's got a good line of fastball. But he pitched three high ones to Bobby Richardson. Mitchell holding the bag against Lynn. Left hander in a set position. Delivers it right in there. Strike call. 3-1. Back to look down at Frank Rossetti. Here's the stretch. The pitch, Lynn's is going, the ball is fouled out of play. And back in the upper deck. Full count on Richardson. In 70 and two-third innings of pitching, Arrigo has walked 29 men. Is high ball four. And Lynn goes to second. Richardson to first. The Yankees with runners at first and second now. No one out. And the batter, Hector Lopez. Lopez batting an even 300. Has six doubles, two triples, six homers, and 21 runs batted in. On deck, Mickey Mantle. Jim Schneider, the second baseman, comes in to talk with Arrigo on the mound. Twins lead 1-0, but the Yankees are threatening here in the bottom of the first. There's a stretch by Arrigo. The pitch to Lopez, taken high as he has squared around the bunt. Ball one. Is going to have Lopez lay one down. Arrigo stretches. His pitch is taken. Ball two, and again Lopez has squared around. So a little streak of wildness getting Arrigo in a jam here in the bottom of the first. Now Batty and Mincher come out to talk with the young left-hander. Second, Richardson at first. No one out. The stretch by Arrigo. His pitch is taken, strike call on the outside corner. Two balls, one strike. Even though on each of the first three pitches, Lopez has squared around as Otobot. Ramos has not come charging in. Here's the stretch. The runners are going. The ball is hit to center field. Allison is going back. Lynch is going back to tag up. He does. And the throw comes in at second base very wisely by Bob Allison, as Richardson had also gone back to tag up. And that's a base running by Lynch. Gets it over to third on a long fly to center field. Lynch was two-thirds of the way down to third base as the hit and run was on. Back to second, tagged up just as Allison made the catch, and easily went to third, and Allison, realizing he couldn't get Lynn to third, fired in a second and kept Richardson at first. And here's Mickey Mantle, batting 327 with a nine-game hitting streak. Picked his 10 doubles, 2 triples, 16 homers, 49 runs batted in. Pitch to Mickey, swing and a miss, right. Line to left field, going back, center through, it's over the fence. trouble. And it kept Richardson from scoring easily and Mantle for making an easy triple. But it ties up the ball game at 1-1 as Lynch comes on to score. And Mantle now gets his 11th double of the year and has 50 runs batted in. Brings up Elston Howard with runners at second and third and one out. And I want to tell you that ball Mantle hit was a line drive. Coming on to score is Richardson. They hold Mickey at third base. That ball was hit so hard that Mantle didn't have a chance to score, and the Yankees lead 2-1. On the first pitch, Elston Howard rips a single to center field, and here comes Dan Neely out of the Twins dugout. That's his 33rd run batted in. Kelly now batting 295 on the air with that base hit. Mickey Mantle batting 330 and now batting right-handed. Mickey has a fantastic average of 529. I'm telling you, almost every time he's up right-handed, he hits a bullet. You can imagine how hard that ball had to be hit to go on the line and take one bounce into the bleachers. Killebrew didn't have a chance for it, and he was playing Mantle deep. All right, Sam Neely, Pat Sorrigo on the back. The Yankees lead 2-1 with one out and runners at first and third, and the batter, Joe Pepitone. Joe batting 261, five doubles, two triples, nine homers, and 41 runs batted in. Pepitone, strike call, sidearm curveball, nick the outside corner. Jim Snyder's playing Pepitone in the hole at second. Here's the stretch. The pitch just outside, 1-1. And as a matter of fact, Snyder just yelled to Rich Rollins, the third baseman, that if the ball is hit to Rollins, he should throw to Versailles, the shortstop, who will cover on the double play. But Snyder is too far away from second to get over there in time. Arrigo sets, runners lead off first and third. The pitch is a curve, line to right field. Arrigo's coming on, he's got it, and Mantle will have to hold that third. That ball was taking off as Oliva dodged it, had a leap high to glove it. Mickey had taken about 3 steps towards home. Then by the time he got back to third to tag up, he had a hold it there. A solid line drive by Joe Pepitone. And the Yankees have really been hitting the ball hard here in the bottom of the first inning. It brings up Freak Boya hitting 214. Five doubles, two triples, four homers, and 22 runs batted in. I don't believe Mantle would have been able to score even if he had been tagging up at third base. Oliva was charging in, caught the ball on a dead run. And he's got a good arm. Here's the stretch. Pitch to Boyer. Curve high. Ball one. Mantle hit the ball so hard that it bounced into the bleachers, only allowing one run to score. Howard hit the ball so hard on a single to center that only one run could score. Mantle had a hold at third. And then Pepitone hit a bullet to right. There's a drive deep. So that's a foul. Way back in the upper deck. He really creamed that one. One strike on Cleet Boyer. Two outs, two on, two runs in. The Yankees leading 2-1. Arrigo stretches. Slow curve, high and outside. Two balls and a strike. Arrigo rubbing up the ball. First, Mantle at third. Here's the stretch. The pitch popped in the air to short right field. Olive is coming in. He's under it and takes it for the third out. For the Yankees in the bottom of the first, two runs on three. three base hits, no twin errors, two men left, and at the end of one full inning, it's the Yankees 2 and the Twins 1. Remember, tickets for all 64 Yankee home games are on sale now. You can buy tickets over the counter at the Yankee Stadium Advance Ticket Office, open daily, Monday through Saturday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., on Sunday from 10 a.m. until 5 p.m., and until after the completion of all night games. Plenty of free parking while you do your quick ticket shopping. Tickets are also on sale at the Yankees' convenient Midtown Ticket Office on the mezzanine of Grand Central Terminal overlooking the main information booth. The Grand Central Ticket Office is open Monday through Friday from 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. and from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. on Saturday. Box and reserve seat reservations also are available at all Schraft's restaurants in the greater New York area. You can order now by mail. Simply send your order to the ticket manager, New York Yankees, Yankee Stadium, Bronx, New York, 10451. Close your check or money order and include your own name and address. Box seats are $3.50, reserve seats $2.50, all tax included. Please add 25 cents to your total order to cover mailing charges. We will pause for station identification.
This is WOKO, Albany, New York. It's 2 minutes and 45 seconds past 2 o'clock.
The Angels playing the Red Sox. It'll be McBride against Wilson. Kansas City at Baltimore, 5:30 p.m. starting time. Washington, Detroit, Cleveland, Chicago later start. And the National League, all the games start later on. Four night games, one day game. The Phillies play the Giants in San Francisco. Earl Batty up, takes a pitch high and outside, ball one. Batty hitting .226. Eight doubles, one triple, six homers, and 29 runs batted in. Jim Bouton on the mound, goes into the windup. Fastball, pop foul, out of play in the upper deck. Batty now has the time. Going back to Jim Snyder in the on-deck circle. Batty had a little trouble holding on to the bat that time. Back to get a little rosin. Now he's all set. Here's the windup by Bob. Curve, low, and outside. Two balls and a strike. Mickey Mantle is moving in under it. Mick gets there and makes the catch. It's one away. That'll bring up Jim Snyder, the second baseman. Snyder batting .250, has two doubles and six runs batted in. Snyder drove in the winning run last night on a sacrifice fly to right field in the 10th inning. Also had a double. Deck is Jerry Arrigo. Snyder bats him right-handed, open stand. About to pitch high and tight, ball one. One out, nobody on. Fastball fouled in the upper deck, out of play, one and one. Are on here at Yankee Stadium. Mantle moves over towards right center now on Snyder. Curve is high and outside, two balls and a strike. Sign from Howard. The windup. Fastball popped in the air and back of the plate. Howard coming back. He's got the room and makes the catch for the second out. That'll bring up Jerry Arrigo, who is batting .190 on the air, 4-for-21. No extra bases, one run batted in. That's him left-handed.
throw a curve swing and a miss. Strike one.
Had a good cut at that curveball. Dallas is playing deep in right field. Fastball swing and a miss. Strike two. Nothing in two. Here's a two-strike set. Curve in the dirt. One ball, two strikes. Twins have won four in a row, their longest winning streak of the season to date. Martin's pitch, swing and a miss, strike three. That's the Twins down in order. Here in the top of the second and at the end of an inning and a half, it's the Yankees two and the Twins one.
Camel time. It's camel time. Camel time. It's pleasure time for you. Camel time. It's any time when nothing less will do. Things all seem to brighten up every time you light one up. Right now, make it camel time. Have camel cigarettes.
Best tobacco makes the best smoke. Camel gives you easygoing taste, honest enjoyment, choice quality tobacco. The exclusive Camel brand of costly tobaccos has never been equal. The best tobacco makes the best smoke.
Right now, make it Camel time. Have Camel cigarettes. Right now, make it Camel time.
Off the Yankees here in the bottom of the second. Pedro playing in place of the injured Roger Maris. Gonzalez batting 258, has one double, two runs batted in. Pedro stretched a single into a double last night. And then in an exciting play, that backfired, tried to steal third on the next pitch and was thrown out on a beautiful throw by Earl Batty. Gonzalez in the batter's box. Origo goes into the windup. His pitch is on the outside corner. Strike one call. One strike delivery inside. Almost hit him on the kneecap. 1-1. Fastball hit on the ground, foul, just outside of third, backhanded by Rollins. One ball, two strikes. On deck is Jim Buss. Not kneeling in the on-deck circle, but about 10 feet to the right of it. Curve hit on the ground at second base. Snyder comes in, has it. Throws to Minter and it's one out. Pedro really hustles down the line. Here is Jim Bosman. Jim has been up 41 times with five base hits. One double, three runs batted in, batting 122. Pitch to Bosman. Right call, fastball just above the knee. One strike pitch, pop foul back out of play into the crowd, back in the Yankee dugout, and a great one-hand catch. And held on to his hot dog with one hand and grabbed the ball with his left hand. Swing and a miss, strike three. Bowden goes down on strikes.
That's the first strikeout for Arrigo. And it brings up Phil Lynn to open the bottom of the first with a single to center and later came around to score. Lynn's batting 238. On deck, Bobby Richardson. Lynn sails high and Arrigo falls down out on the mound as he trips. One ball. Arrigo has a nice, smooth, easy delivery, and that ball shoots in. The pitch is taken for a strike, one of one. And on the big scoreboard it says, Happy Birthday, USA, 188 years old today. And a good friend of mine, Mr. Peter Rossi, up in the Pocono, celebrating his 81st birthday today. He's almost got half of the 188. There's a pitch low, two balls and a strike. Wind up a 2-1 pitch inside, 3-1. Sort of blew air into his cheek. Thought that pitch had the inside corner. Two out, nobody on. 2-1, the Yankees lead. 3-1 delivery. Inside, ball four. Second walk given up by Arrigo. Lynn goes down to first. Here's Richardson. Bobby walked his first time up. Batting 250. Lopez. Lynn has now hit in 8 consecutive ball games with his single in the first inning. Throw to first base, Lynn is back. Pretty tricky move by Arrigo over to first. Here's the stretch. Curve, bunted, tap, missed, strike one. A good breaking curveball. Bobby tried to drop one down third base. Not the fastest third baseman in the American League and plays a fairly deep third base. Especially with a fellow like Richardson up there. Here's the stretch. Way outside, almost a wild pitch. Batty had a lunge far to his right and backhand that ball. 1-1. Arrigo started in as though to talk with Batty and then turned around and walked back to the mound. Big lead at first. Arrigo set. His pitch is on the inside corner. Strike two call. One ball, two strikes. Arrigo rubs the ball up after every pitch. Here's the set. And the count's even at 2-2. Lynn is really bouncing off that bag, getting a bigger lead each time on Arrigo. Wouldn't be surprised to see him try and steal the bag on this pitch. Takes a long look. Now he's ready. The pitch is popped in a short left field. That ball's going to drop in for a base hit. Lynn grabs the bag and holds on, and Richardson gets a little Texas League single right off the handle of his bat in the short left field. That's the fourth hit for the Yankees. For Richardson, his 84th hit of the year, and it brings up Hector Lopez. Hector flying to center field in the first inning, batting 298. Have runners at first and second. Oscar Lopez hit high in the air to right field. Oliva could have no trouble with this one. He's right there and puts it away for the third out. For the Yankees in the bottom of the second. No runs, one hit. No twin errors, two men left. And at the end of two full innings, it's the Yankees 2 and the Twins 1.
Charter boat. Put down the deck. Guys fishing. Pulling them in.
Look at that fun.
Flapping it up.
All the air, blazing fun.
Fishing fun.
Valentine.
Wow! You got a smile.
Look for the special totem pole display and tote home plenty Valentine beer. For the Twins, it'll be the top of their batting order, facing Jim Bott for the second time in this game. Curl over size, who's single to right, stole second and then scored on a single, will be leading off. For size, batting 272. Rich Rollins with Tony Oliva to follow. Out into the windup. His pitch at bluff fun. The pitch is way high. Ball one. Out next pitch. He bluffs a bunt. Comes back to swing. Then bluffs another bunt. And it's ball two, and he did that all within the space of a fraction of a second that it takes that ball to get from the pitcher's box to home plate. The 2-0 pitch. Again, he bluffs it, but takes a strike this time, 2-1. Ball hit high in the air to center field. Mickey Mantle moves in a couple of steps, is there and takes it. It's one away. That'll bring up Rich Rollins, who struck out in the first inning. Rollins batting at 266. This is the top of the third inning. Last night by this time we had played almost six innings. Fastball game. This is a curve that's high. Ball one. Fastball foul out of play and over the roof and out of Yankee Stadium. Strike one out. Nobody on. On deck, Tony Oliva. Change of pace high. Two balls and a strike. Bowden's 2-1 delivery is a foul back to the screen. 2-2. Thank you. shift their infield on Rollins, play three men between second and third. But now they play him almost straight away. The curve is line to left center field, a base hit. Mantle over to his right, coming in fast, up with it. Rollins makes the turn and holds on with a line single. Fourth hit for the Twins. Here's Tony Oliva, who lined a single to center field to drive in the Twins' run in the first inning. Oliva batting 335, now has 109 base hits and 49 runs batted in. What a year he's having as a rookie. 17 doubles, 5 triples, and 17 homers. On deck, Harmon Killebrew. Rollins at first with one out. Stretch the pitch to Oliva, fouled out of play in the upper deck. Hits the light towers and back down into the lower box seat. One thing we've noticed about Oliva in the games we've seen him play against the Yankees, he's a good bad ball hitter, besides being a good ball hitter. He can stretch out or hit the low pitches and just got that good stroke. Strike on Tony. Stretch by Bowden. His pitch is on the inside corner, strike two. Nothing in two. Oliva, at least today, seems to have trouble with the inside curve or inside fastball just next to corner. Fastball line at center field. Mickey Mantle drops in, goes back, and makes a one-hand backhand catch. And busting back to first is Rollins. Boy, he is a high ball hitter. I tell you, he really stroked that one. It was a nothing and two count to Oliva, and Bowden got the pitch up around his eyes over the plate. He likes the pitch away from him. And here's Harmon Killebrew, who singled over at center field in the first inning. Killebrew batting 281. Two outs. Runner at first. Yankees lead 2-1. We're in the top of the third. Pitch to Killebrew. Curve outside. Ball one. On deck, Bob Allison. Now looks over at Rollins, leading at first. Pitch to Killebrew high and inside. Two balls, no strike. Gotta be careful with this fella. He has really got the power. 28 home runs, leading the major league. Killebrew. 2-0 pitch. Low and outside, ball three. Killebrew steps back to look down at Floyd Baker, see if he's got the green light. Howard walks out now, halfway to the mound, to tell Bowden, be on the alert, he might be swinging 3-0. And out, relax. It's taken for a strike on the inside corner. Well, it looks like they had Killebrew taken, but he stepped back again to look down at Floyd Baker. But he'll be ready to swing now. The stretch, the pitch is swinging a foul back in the upper deck. Full count. Different objects up there. And now Howard goes out to the mound, all the way this time to talk with Bowden. 3-2, two out. Rollins will be running. Yankees leading 2-1 in the top of the third inning. It's a curve outside, ball four. Rollins moves to second. Gilbert to first on the first walk given up by Bob. It brings up Bob Allison, who is bumped to the shortstop his first time up, hitting 339. Allison has been just about the hottest hitter in the American League over the past month and a half. Rollins at second, Killebrew at first. Stretch by Bob. Pitch to Allison, hit high in the air to right center field. Now Gonzalez driving in, goes back, backing up and makes it just in front of the auxiliary scoreboard. Oh, man, Gonzalez had come in about three steps and then really had a high tail back. For the Twins in the top of the third, no runs, one hit, no Yankee errors, two men left. At the end of two and a half, it's the Yankees two and the Twins one.
While there's a pause in the game, let's make ourselves comfortable and light up a Camel. Camel time is pleasure time. It's a time that's all your own. A happy time that calls for only one cigarette, a Camel. And nothing less than a Camel will do. Things all seem to brighten up every time you light one up. Camel gives you easy-going taste, honest enjoyment. How come? Well, the reason's in the blend. The exclusive Camel blend of costly choice quality tobaccos has never been equaled. The best tobacco makes the best smoke. Make it Camel time, right now.
Right now, make it Camel time.
Station identification.
This is WOKO, Albany, New York.
Mickey Mantle batting 331, doubled one hop into the left center field bleachers first time up, driving in a run. Arrigo's pitch is low, ball one. Stand of Arrigo. Pitch low inside. Ball two to another. On deck, Elston Howard. Two-nothing delivery. Swing and a miss. Strike one. Now, what a cut Nick had at that one. Pulled Rich Rollins back about three strides at third base, almost to the edge of the outfield grass. When Mantle's up there and you're playing third, you can't get back too far. 2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike two. He hit the outside corner with that fastball. 2-2. Up Elston the first inning was on second when Lopez fly deep to center. Tagged up, went to third after the catch. Mantle here in the bottom of the third. Tagged up and went to second. Here's Pepitone, who lined to right field first time up. Takes the strike on the outside corner. Pepitone batting 260. Yankees leading 2-1 here in the bottom of the third inning. First game for doubleheader. Still loads of time to get out here for the rest of this game and all of the second game. Rigo sets. His curve hits deep to right field. Way back there. Ball is gone. Bullpen for a home run. Joe Pepitone getting his 10th home of the year. Now has 43 runs batted in. Lead 4-1, and Sam Bailey is coming out of the Twin dugout. For Pepitone, that's his second home run off Minnesota pitching. He hit one off Ken Perry on June the 4th at Minnesota. And Pepitone really laid the wood to this one. About halfway back in the Yankee bullpen. Coming on now for the Twins. Arrigo has worked just 2 1/3 innings. He has allowed 6 base hits, has walked 2, has struck out 1, and has allowed 4 runs. So that closes the book on Arrigo. He is out of the ball game. Jim Perry coming on. We were just talking about Jim. He was the fellow that Pepitone homered off up in Minnesota. Perry is making his 19th appearance of the year. He is 1-2 and lost 1. Led the total of 24 innings, given up 27 hits, 3 homers, and has allowed 13 runs. Perry is 6'4", 190 pounds, from Martin County, North Carolina. So the Yankees get the first home run of this four-game series. Everyone expected a real bombardment of home runs. A regal lead. And now Jim Rowland gets up in the Twin bullpen. Won his last 4 decisions, 3 as a starter and 1 in relief. Definitely cannot win this game, but the Twins, of course, could take him off the hook as a losing pitcher if they tie up the game. Lee Foyer, who will fly to right field in the first inning, will be the first man to face Jim Perry. Foyer batting 213. Yankees now have 6 hits, the Twins 4. Thing, that first time Pepitone was up, he hit a bullet to right field. And if Oliva had not caught that ball, that thing was just taken off, it would have gone into the seats in right field. That was really hit. All right, Perry is ready. Boyer steps into the batter's box. On deck, Pedro Gonzalez. His pitch, the ground ball hit to the mound. Perry over, up with it, goes to first, just in time to get Boyle by one step. two away, and it brings up Gonzalez, who bounced to second base in the second inning. Two men out, no one on. Yankees four, Twins one, here in the bottom of the third. Jim Buck. Pitch to Gonzalez. Swing and a miss. Strike one at a high fastball. Big right handle leans in. Foul, that's coming back out of play. Nothing in two on Gonzalez. Perry is 6 feet 4 inches tall and 190 pounds. His brother pitches for the San Francisco Giants, Gaylord Perry. Now the two-strike pitch. Just outside. Two balls and one strike. Two men are out. One ball, two strike delivery. Fouled out of play and back of first base. Into the stand. Count holds at 1-2. The Yankees have 73 home runs now with Pepitone Soma, and the Twins have 121. They lead the majors in home runs. Swings into the windup. Strike three. Couldn't check his swing on a high fastball. Well, the Yankees, they come up with two runs, two hits, no twin errors, nobody left, and at the end of three full innings, it's the Yankees four and the Twins one. Right now, I'd like to say that the next portion of this game will be brought to you by Valentine Beer. Beer after beer, the most refreshing around. So smile, settle back, and enjoy baseball and ice cold Valentine Beer. Scoreboard, the Angels failed to score in the top of the first. And in the bottom of the first, Lee Thomas has just hit a grand slammer, a homer with the bases loaded. Off McBride, Bob Lee has come in to relieve him. Wilson going for the Red Sox. Kansas City at Baltimore, 5:30 start. Washington at Detroit will be Osteen against Wickersham. Cleveland at Chicago, McDowell against Peters. And the National League, the Mets meet the Dodgers tonight. Philadelphia, San Francisco, a latest start. Pittsburgh at Houston, St. Louis at Cincinnati, and Chicago at Milwaukee, all night games. Jim Bouton is loosening up, ready to pitch to Don Mincher here in the top of the fourth inning. The Twins scored in the first inning. The Yankees scored two in the first and two in the third. And don't forget, the Twins will be here tomorrow afternoon to wind up this four-game set. A single game starting at 1:30. And it'll be Whitey Ford for the Yankees and Jim Mudcat Grant for Minnesota. Mincher popped up to second base his first time at bat. Jim Bob ready. Here's his first pitch to Mincher.
Oh, he hit one. That's gone. A whole bunch for Don Mincher. I mean, he really hit it. The first pitch was a high fastball, and he lined it into the right field seat. And here to tell you about that homer is Canales.
Phil. Hello there, everybody. Don Mincher, who won the ball game yesterday with a 10th inning triple. Homers to open the fourth. Earl Batty swings the first pitch, lifts a high fly ball to right center. Gonzalez and Mantle, and it's Mantle drifting under for the catch. Comes up. The pitch on the way is swung on, hit over the head of Lynn, that took a high bounce, and Snyder turns first, pulls up as the ball comes back from Hector Lopez. It looked like a sharp one hopper right at Lynn. The ball, as it landed, suddenly took off over his head in the left for a base hit. Now we're going to have a pinch hitter for Jim Perry. Jimmy Hall will hit for Perry. Had a sore back, and that's the reason he's been out of action primarily. They told us he was also in a bit of a slump. But this is a slump-breaking ballpark for visiting teams. Just as if you were playing a game of handball and you were a good handball player. You wouldn't put out everything you had against somebody who wasn't good. When you went against somebody that was good, you just played better, that's all. The pitch is swung on, has a drive, and he's right, but Gonzalez comes in and smashes. The ball sank. He'd have gotten up front of that one a little bit, it'd have been in the seat. First ball hitting by the Twins last night and today. Zorro Versalas coming up. Snyder on first, two down. Versalas single to right and fly to center. Forfeit score. The pitch is swung on and fouled off to the right of the plate as Versalas, looking for a breaking pitch, tried to punch it into right field and fouled it off to the right of the plate. One of the oddities of sports to me is that the forfeit score in baseball is 9-0, and in football it's 1-0. Now the pitch, swung on and fouled to the left of the plate. One ball, two strikes. I never have even thought about it. Probably a running inning. Here's the pitch. High, ball two, 2-2. Football, you just have to give you a margin of victory.
Strike one and one.
swing on and miss. Strike two, one and two.
Wednesday afternoon at 2, a suburban night on the 16th, Thursday, 6 o'clock.
Washington and Detroit scoreless at the end of an inning. Osteen against Wickersham. Cleveland nothing. Chicago batting in the first inning. McDowell against Peters. Nothing to report yet in the National League. Second game today, Pasquale against Downing. Tomorrow, Ford against Glenn. Plenty of room out here if you'd like to see some of this game and all of the second. Now, I'll tell you one thing. The baseball out here has really been of the thrilling variety. Now, Rich Rollins in the fifth inning takes it inside for a ball. Hitting second in the order. Struck out, single to center. Olive on deck, Killebrew to follow. The denizens of Dynamite at bat. And the pitch. Swung on, foul back up on Finetti. A 1-1 count. Because of the theory that we speculate on, Fountain throwing some breaking pitches to Rollins, Richardson's not playing the overshift on him. They don't do it with the runner on, of course, but they have been doing it. Three men between second and third, nobody on. However, Bobby is playing to the right of second. The pitch is a let-up. Delivery this high. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. The letters, a change of pace. Full count, 3-2. The payoff pitch. Swung on. There's a high fly ball to deep right center. Gonzalez goes over 100 and has it. That way, but as you noted, he kept fouling them off in that direction. Now Tony Oliva, single to center and line to center. Currently batting 335. He and Mantle are neck and neck. Mantle went to 333. Last time up. The pitch to the left-hand batter swung on and fouled to the left of the plate. Strike one, nothing at one. Not in time. 60 runs batted in. He singled and walked. The pitch swung on and fouled back. So he made Oliva hit where he wanted him to in general, to the opposite field instead of pulling. But he hit it where they weren't. A wicked liner. Now the pitch to Killebrew. Swung on, line foul down the left field line. Two strikes. Steve Hamilton walking back into the bullpen area, whether to throw or answer the phone or say hello to somebody, I don't know. We'll find out as soon as possible. Now the pitch, swung on and missed. Good turn, strike three. Bob Allison coming up. Pops to short, fly to right. Entered the game today, leading the league and hitting 340. Now the pitch. High, ball one. One ball, no strikes. 4-3, another one-run contest. May not be that way long. And the pitch. Over that inside corner, strike one, 1-1. A 1-1 count on Allison. Has started to throw. Bouncy's pitch is outside to Bob, 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Oliva getting the inside homer, batting 336. Allison bounces one foul down the third baseline. Has dropped to 337, and Mantle has moved up to 335, so we've got a sideline story going. One point separating three men for the American League lead in batting. Naturally, that'd be more exciting on the last day of the year. But it's interesting enough at present. Come on out, see the ball game. And the second one, the pitch swung on and missed. Strike three. And now Allison going out might be down to 336, possibly 335. At this stage of the game, you don't lose too much. Sometimes you stay the same. You lose a half a point, maybe a whole point. One run, one hit, no errors, no one left on. And Allison is hitting 336. Oliva 336 and Mantle 335. We have to carry the two 336s out to the final decimal point to see which one's ahead, but it doesn't matter at this point. At the end of 4.5 innings, Yanks 4, Twins 3.
No more Valentine's here, huh, Joe?
Valentine's here. Neighborhood Tavern, Friday night.
Come on in. Join the crowd.
Look at the guy.
Having a ball.
Shuffleboard.
A couple of beers.
Tavern, friends.
Valentine.
Wow!
You've got a smile that's retired with us. Valentine.
Wow!
What a beer that's Valentine.
Beer on deck. Have another.
Set them up.
Oh, brother.
Wow!
In the last half of the fifth, 4-3, New York. Mickey Mantle up left-handed, takes inside from Johnny Klipstein, ball one. Mantle batting right-handed, double to left and single to left, hitting
335. The pitch is wide, ball two. Howard and Pepitone to follow. Versalas has ranged far over towards second for a pitch. Now the pitch, way outside, ball three. The Twins are in what you would call a semi-type overshift, or a three-quarters overshift. Rollins very wide of third. The 3-0 delivery. It's in there, strike one, 3-1. Three balls, one strike. The windup by Klipstein. The pitch swung on and missed. Strike two. Fastball that tailed away from Mantle. A full count. Klipstein into the windup. Around comes the arm. The pitch is swung on and missed. Strike three. One away in the fifth inning. Johnny, behind 3-0, came back to strike him out. Here's Elston Howard, who singled to center and flied to left. Mantle will jump up and down more in the averages than the others since he has not been charged with as many times at bat. Now Howard takes the strike, 0-1. Howard once beat Klipstein in this ballpark with a home run from the left field stand when he was with Cleveland. The pitch swung on, good curve, low outside, strike two. Three, New York. Last half of the fifth. And a two-strike pitch to Ellie. Curve outside, ball one, 1-2. Went right
broke off the bag with Pepitone, but only got a step, and Stott went right back and grabbed it. In fact, his momentum carried him a step into foul territory, and just reached back and tagged the bag. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left on. At the end of five innings, New York four runs, eight hits, no errors, six left on. The Twins, three runs, seven hits, no errors, and four men left on base.
Tobacco makes the best smoke. Camel gives you easygoing taste, honest enjoyment, choice quality tobaccos. The exclusive Camel blend of costly tobaccos has never been equaled. The best tobacco makes the best smoke.
Right now, make it Camel time. Have a Camel cigarette.
Sixth inning, Don Mincher leading off, and the pitch swung on, a bouncer hit to Richardson. He grabs it on the grass, flips to Pepitone in time. Bobby Angle on it went on the grass a step. Mincher had homered in the fourth, popped out the second and the first. Earl Batty comes up by the center twice. Mantle, if you're interested, dropped down to 332 from the 335 he was hitting. The pitch is over the outside corner for a strike. Nothing in one. Next delivery is outside. Ball one, one and one. Boston 9, Angels nothing, end of 3. Tigers 2, Senators nothing, end of 2. Cleveland, Chicago scoreless, end of 1. Next pitch is swung on, a high drive to left. Lopez makes the catch. Two away. Kansas City at Baltimore will start at 5:30. This is the only doubleheader of the majors today. Was a doubleheader July 4th, sort of a traditional sort of thing. But hitting on a Saturday, now the teams is playing, all the other teams is playing one today and probably two tomorrow. I haven't looked at tomorrow's schedule. Here is Jim Snyder. The pitch is inside for a ball. One ball, no strikes. There's been a tendency in recent years on the part of some teams to play one game on a holiday and two the next day. Or if the holiday comes on a Monday, they'll play two on Sunday and one on Monday, or one on Sunday and two on Monday. In other words, one always knew what to expect in the past, but now you just don't. Here's the pitch, and it's outside, ball two. Delivery swung on and popped high down the third baseline. Lynn's under it in fair territory. Drips to his left and makes the catch. And the side is retired. No runs, no hits, no errors, no one left on. At the end of five and a half innings, New York 4, Minnesota 3.
Valentine beer, Valentine beer. Summertime's a thirsty time. Don't run out of old Valentine. Look for the toast of old sign. Toast home plenty. Toast home plenty, Valentine. Summer's Valentine, the thirsty kind. Don't run out of cold Valentine. Look for the totem pole sign. Totem plenty. Totem all plenty. Valentine beer. Totem all plenty. Valentine.
Nothing turns your thirst to a smile faster than a cold, crisp Valentine. So it's wise to keep plenty on ice. Next time you shop, look for the Valentine totem pole sign. It's a reminder to tote home plenty of Valentine. Tote home plenty Valentine beer and get a smile every time.
In the last half of the sixth inning, the Yankees leading 4-3. Gonzalez, Fountain, and then Lynn's coming up. As we've checked both leagues tomorrow, and the event you're interested, there are only two doubleheaders tomorrow, Washington at Detroit, Cleveland at Chicago. Everything else will be at night, and I mean single games, with one night game at Houston. Gonzalez grounded to second and struck out. Johnny Kupstein, the right-hander, delivers. The pitch is bunted toward third. It's a pretty one. Rollins goes, but it is safe. Expecting the bunt, scooped it barehanded. But Gonzalez had to jump on him. And now here's Jim Fountain, who twice has struck out, the last time looking. Rollins moves in anticipation of the bunt. Mincher holding against the runner, ready to break in. And the pitch. It's bunted, but in the air, foul to the right of the plate, out of play, strike one. Downing and Camilo Pascual will be the pitchers in the second game today. We have the room. So why don't you zoom? I don't know. Now the pitch. It's low for a ball. 1-1. Ford and Grant tomorrow. In and the ball is inside to Fountain. Ball two, high and inside. Pitching coach Gordon Maltzberger just signaled to the bullpen, and two men get up to go back. Out of sight, but not out of mind. Two balls, one strike. And the pitch. It's inside, ball three, 3-1. Puts down to the stretch, Gonzalez with the lead. The pitch, and it is in there, strike two. They had the take on. Count on Fountain, who looks at Crissetti. Time calls. Gonzalez wants to check with Jim Gleason first on the side. He wants to know whether he's to be off and running, whether the bunt is on, or the swing is on. He knows the game is on and it's sizzling. And we got another one to go, and I hope you'll be out. Now the stretch. The runner's not going. The ball is bunted at and missed. Strike three. Third time Fountain struck out. Up comes Phil Lynn. Single to center, walk, and fly to center. It's a tough pitch to bunt because Lipstein threw a breaking pitch and it broke down low. Actually, it's an easy pitch to bunt if you'd known what was coming. You know that a certain pitch is coming can be tough to bunt. That's that high blazer. Pitch to Lynn. Swung on, hit foul down the right field line, out of play. Thank you.
afraid a fellow from trying to steal. Here's the pitch. It's a pitch out. The runner's not going. Throw down to first. He's back. Matty nailed Gonzalez last night trying to steal third shortly after he had stretched the single into a double. With Rollins deep, took a perfect throw to get him, and Gonzalez was gotten in the last of the ninth. One ball, one strike. And the pitch swung on line by third to left field for a base hit. Gonzalez turns second, holds up. Killebrew hits the throw to third. Cut off by Gonzalez. So there was a situation. With Rollins guarding that line, that gap open because there was a line drive. Gonzalez couldn't get over to that one. This points up the value of an ability to move a runner up. Failure to bunt cost him a run. Here is Bobby Richardson, who walks single to left and single to right. One out. The pitch is a curve low outside for a ball. Swung on and missed. Strike one. One and one. It was in this type of situation that Gonzalez tried to steal third. He wanted to get over with one out so he'd be in position to score on a fly ball. That was last night. Here's the pitch. Bounce, and Gonzalez can try to go to third, and he is safe. On a pitch into the dirt, clock. Bounced in front of him, but not far, and Gonzalez, despite being thrown out last night, and with Batty out in front of the plate this time to pick up the ball, he gambled and made it. I want you to know that ball was there about the time he was, though. His slide took him around the tag. It has to be scored a wild pitch. Runners on first and third, one out. Two balls, one strike on Richardson. 4-3 New York, sixth inning. There goes Lins. The pitch is swung on and fouled back out of play. Strike two, 2-2. Lins is breaking, setting himself up for a line drive type of double play, but on the other hand, trying to beat the percentage of a ground ball double play. Many other factors. A long ball, such as a double, could have scored him from first. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Time. Gonzalez has to talk to Grissetti now to check on the sign. He checks with Gleason, nice check with Grissetti. Where was Gonzalez in the batting order last night? 7th or 8th. There's the pitch, and it's outside. Ball three. See, he batted 8th last night, so as he is today. To be sure, not being in the game often enough, what the signs may be, whether to play run and hit, steal. Full count, one out, or squeeze. 4-3 New York, sixth inning. There goes Lins. The pitch is swung on, bounced to third. Rollins up, and it throws to the plate. Gonzalez is trapped. Batty to Rollins. There comes Gonzalez. He hits the dirt, and he is out of the plate with good time covering. Lins goes to third, and Richardson to second. He had to come home. To spoil a possibility of a double play. So Gonzalez is out. Rollins to Batty. Back to Rollins to Klipstein covering. On a fielder's choice play. With Lins going on to third and Richardson to second. At that, though, in retrospect, the ball is not too sharply hit. I don't know whether they've gotten the double play or not. But it's the same thing. You got runners on second and third, and he gambled on. Which would have been the same thing if he'd gotten the hitter. Two outs, and Hector Lopez up. Fly to center, right, rounded to short. Takes a fastball, and sails high and inside. Ball one. With Batty having to reach high. pitch it over. You know, Gonzalez actually outran Rollins finally toward the plate, and Klipstein had to cover. Runners lead away from second and third, two down. The pitch swung on, hit to the box. Klipstein, a venture in the side, is retired. On, and at the end of six innings, the Yankees four runs, 10 hits, no errors, eight men left on, Minnesota three runs, seven hits, no errors, and five men left on base.
And now, on to the next portion of this ball game, brought to you by the Atlantic Refining Company and your neighborhood Atlantic dealer, the folks who offer you Atlantic Imperial, the gasoline that cleans your carburetor and keeps it clean.
Elsewhere, Boston leads Los Angeles 9-1, then to 4.5 innings. Wilson for Boston, McBride, Bob Lee in the first, Myers the second for the Angels, Thomas a grand slammer, Boston 9 runs in the first inning. Kansas City, Baltimore at 5:30. Detroit 2, Washington nothing, 10-2.5, Osteen and Wickersham. Cleveland and Chicago scoreless at 10-2.5, McDowell and Peters. In the National League, the only afternoon action will be Philadelphia at San Francisco. All the other action tonight. Second game, Downing and Pasquale. Come on out. Tomorrow, it's Ford and Grant. Single game, 1:30. Jerry Coleman coming on as we get ready to go to the seventh inning of another squeaker at Yankee Stadium. Frank Castro is coming up to pinch hit for Johnny Klipstein. Coming up to take over, as we told you, Mary Jerry.
Thank you, Mel. And as I come on, here comes Frank Castro, the bat for Johnny Klipstein here in the top of the seventh inning. A 4-3 ball game. The Yankees leading the Twins. Frank Castro was originally the property of the Detroit Tigers and drifted in their minor league system for several years. Finally got to the big leagues with Detroit briefly in 1962, then was with the Angels briefly in 1963, as well as Detroit. He takes a strike right in there from Jim Bouton. Right-hand batter. He'll be 27 on August the 4th. The one strike pitch to Castro, as then the dirt gets away from Howard, 1-1 the count. 4-3 ball game, a real squeaker here at the stadium. Once again, another one that we've had them. The Yankees leading 4-3. They have 10 hits, the Twins 7. Jim into the windup. Here's one foul just off to our right. And almost hit the game of the week. Camera just off to our right. It's 1-2 now to Frank Castro, batting for Johnny Klipstein. Sound delivers. There's a hard foul down the third base side. They have a couple of fellas. They used to have kids, but now these are part of the ground crew, and they sit down the foul lines and right and left, and they don't catch the ball as good as those kids do. They have a little problem with it. That ball bounced three or four times before that guy came up with it. All right, 1-2. The pitch is on the way to Castro. Pops it in the air on the infield. Boyer coming in and calling for it right behind the mound. He takes it, and there's one away. Now, as Oliver Sally comes on, let's pause for station identification.
This is WOKO, Albany, New York.
Sally, single to right, fly to center, fly to left. Fine young shortstop for the Twins as Bouton is into the windup. The pitch is a strike right down the middle. Lynn was on the move with Versalli batting. These are tough guys, men with speed who can bunt the ball. You have to play them close, particularly the third baseman. Now the one strike pitch for a Jim. Big change up curve. Hit down the line. Hector Lopez going over. He's got a chance for it right almost on the foul line and takes it. That ball sort of came back a little bit. We thought for a minute it might go into the stands down at the corner in deep left field. The wind, as we look now, is blowing from left to right center. So that may have had something to do with holding that ball in there. All right, two down. Now here's Rich Rollins. Struck out. Single to left and fly to right. He's one for three. Jim Bouton in there all the way for the Yankees. Delivers a high slider. Strike one. Game, Yanks leading, top of the seventh. Bouton ready again. The pitch to Rollins. Change up. Hits deep in the hole. Boyer back has it. The long throw in time. What a play. Reed Boyer going way in the hole, backhanding it and coming up firing to get Rollins to retire the side. For the Twins, three up, three down. The score after six and a half. The Yankees four runs on 10 hits. Minnesota three runs on 7 hits.
A ball player knows the showers, the easiest way to get rid of the dirt and dust after a hard-played game. And you should know that Atlantic Imperial is the easiest way to wash away the dirt in your carburetor. You see, some gasolines allow dirt deposits to build up around the throttle plate area in your automobile carburetor. But Atlantic Imperial gasoline washes those deposits away and keeps your carburetor clean. You can be sure it will. Atlantic is so sure, they make this guarantee. Register with your Atlantic dealer. Then after you've used 100 gallons of Atlantic Imperial gasoline, your carburetor will be clean, or Atlantic will pay to have it cleaned, according to a liberal payment schedule. So, the next time you need gasoline, choose the one that's guaranteed. Fill up with Atlantic Imperial, the gasoline that's guaranteed to clean your carburetor and keep it clean.
Stranger to New York fans, coming on to pitch for the Twins here. He's the fourth Twin pitcher in this ball game. He'll be facing Mickey Mantle. Worthington is making his third appearance for the Twins. He has a record of 1-0, both appearances in relief. He was purchased by the Twins from the San Diego club of the Pacific Coast League on June the 26th. Al Worthington, he was a Giant in 1953, 54, 56, and 57. Then went out to the coast with the Giants in 58-9 before being traded to the Boston Red Sox in the American League. Al Worthington, and he'll be facing Mickey Mantle. Mantle, double, single, struck out. Worthington, right-handed sinker baller, delivers, and Mantle fouls this one off of the plate. Strike one. Well, you know, they say that curiosity killed the cat, but, well, I just can't help but being curious about the goings-on before the July 18th Cleveland Yankee game. It's something big. 1 hour before game time, and, well, I guess I can wait till tomorrow's game when we'll all find out together, so be sure and tune in. A one-strike pitch to Mantle is hit softly off to the left into the stands and out of play. Al Worthington. He's been around a few years. Into the windup, the two-strike pitch to Mantle is way outside, 1-2. Worthington is 35 years old. Born in Birmingham, Alabama. He's 6 feet 2 inches tall, 210 pounds. He still makes his home in Birmingham. All right, the 1-2 pitch to Mantle. He's outside, 2-2 the count. We're in the last of the seventh inning with the Yankees leading 4-3. Nobody on and nobody out. It's all even to the mix. Two balls, two strikes. Into the windup. 2-2 pitches outside, a full count.
line for a doubleheader.
Now the payoff pitch to Mickey, foul drive back to the left. 188 years ago, they signed the Declaration of Independence. And a few fans are celebrating here with some firecrackers that explode from time to time. Second game, we'll see Al Downing and Camilo Pasquale going at it. Payoff pitch to Mickey. It's hard and far to right field. Going to the barrier, Oliva, and he takes it. Tony Oliva taking Donald's hard smash right at the barrier. Well, Mickey is round to the home run, and there's one away, and the batter will be Elston Howard. Donald didn't get the good wood to that ball, but for a moment it appeared as though it might be down the line enough to go in. Worthington, the first pitch to Howard. Strike called on the outside corner. Ellie singled to center, fly to left, struck out. Worthington ready again. The one strike pitch to Ellie. Knuckleball. Earl Batty, good to handle. 1-1. Bill Valentine, the plate umpire, picked up the ball and gave it the once over as if to say, what was that? That was a good one, though, a little bit low. All right, 1-1 to Howard. One out, nobody on. 4-3 ball game. Bottom of the seventh. Yankees leading. Worthington ready again. The 1-1 pitch is another knuckleball. A bat powered off the plate. Two balls and a strike. Frequently, you will find experienced pitchers like Worthington who have lost their fastball come up with a good pitch like a knuckleball. And when they can control it, they're tough. Howard swings and misses at a curve. 2-2. Worthington, the fourth twin pitcher in this ballgame. Now the 2-2 pitch to Howard. It hit up the middle base hit. He got a high curveball up around Ellie's letters. So Howard with one away, singles sharply into center field. And here's Joe Pepitone. That's the second hit for Howard and the first off Worthington in this game. Down has hit the ball hard all day. He lined to right, hit a two-run homer to right, and then singled to left. Been getting a good wood to the ball. Howard leading off at first with one away. The pitch to Pepitone is in there. Strike one. Don't forget the Yankees and the Twins tomorrow afternoon, a single game. Game time, 1:30. And then the All-Star break. Six of the American League All-Stars are in this game today. Allison, Gillibrew, and Oliva for the Twins. Howard, Richardson, and Mapple for the Yankees. Pepitone hits a high fly ball to straightaway center. Bob Allison drifting in, getting under it, and he takes it. And Howard tags up and takes about five big steps towards second base. And it changes his mind. Two away. Now here's Boyer. Boyer flied to right. Bounced back to the pitcher. All right, Al Worthington in the set position. Delivers to Boyer. It's a curveball high. Ball one. Elston at first base. Yankees with 11 hits. Four runs. The Twins, seven hits and three runs. Worthington again, swung on a miss by Boyer, 1-1. Worthington, that time is called as a ball or something was thrown on the field down the right field line, and the ball boy, or the ball man, I should say, goes over there and gets it and returns it to whoever threw it. 1-1 pitch to Boyer is low. Two balls and a strike. And it looks like the sun is trying to creep out here. We have had nothing but gray overcast skies today, but right now it looks like the sun is trying to creep out. Okay, the 2-1 pitch to Cleese. Come on, miss. Strike two. 2-2. Well, that Worthington really goes for those corners.
Two balls, two strikes, two down. Boyer the batter. Howard at first base. Last of the seventh, the Yankees leading 4-3. Worthington sets the pitch to Cleet way outside. Full count. Outside ball four, and he lost him. Oh, the first walk given up by Worthington. Put Boyer at first base, then Nelson Howard down to second. And now here's Pedro Gonzalez, who bounced to second, struck out, and had a bunt single. Beautiful ball, and he laid it right down to third base side. Rollins, no chance to get it. Although he did make a fine play in an attempt, as Gonzalez went down the line for the hit. Ball with a knuckleball way inside, back Pedro off the plate. One ball, no strike. Worthington ready again. The runners at first and second lead off. The pitch to Gonzalez to hit into center field. Bob Allison moving over, getting under it. He takes it. All right, for the Yankees in the bottom of the seventh. No runs, one hit, no twin errors, two men left. The score after seven full innings of play, the Yanks 4, Minnesota 3.
Say, if you're like millions of other people, you'll probably be taking the family to New York this summer to take in the spectacular New York World's Fair. What a show, and what a good time awaits you. But remember, you haven't seen New York till you see one of its most exciting attractions, the New York Yankees at Yankee Stadium. The most famous team in baseball, playing in the most famous stadium in baseball. It's baseball at its big league best. A game at Yankee Stadium is something you, and especially the kids, will remember for a long time. And Yankee Stadium is so easy to get to. Just a 15 or 20 minute drive from Midtown New York, or take the subway, another of New York's famous attractions. It leaves you off right in front of the stadium. So if you're coming to New York, remember, you haven't seen New York till you see the world famous New York Yankees at historic Yankee Stadium. See you at Yankee Stadium.
Valley singled and scored a run in the first inning. Joe Sepp
zone. Hit a two-run homer for the Yankees in the third. 4-3 game. Yankees leading. We're at the top of the eighth. Nobody out, nobody on. Bound into the windup. The pitch to Oliva. Strike right in there. 2-1. Generally speaking, July the 4th is a big doubleheader day in the major leagues, but today the only doubleheader being played in either league is here at Yankee Stadium. All the other contests are single games. Bout holding on to a one-run lead. The Yankees lead 4-3, and a 2-1 pitch to Oliva is low, 3-1 to count. Harmon Killebrew in the on-deck circle. Seven and a half.
Minnesota 5 runs on 8 hits. The Yankees 4 runs on 11 hits. Johnny Blanchard coming on to bat for Jim Bouncey. And as he does, let's pause for station identification. Inning, Blanchard coming on for Bouncey. Yankees trailing in the game, 5-4. Another thriller here at the stadium. Yesterday, the Twins beat the Yankees 1-0 in 10 innings. So right now, we have action. Blanchard batting for Bouncey. Al Worthing, the fourth Twin pitcher, into the windup. The pitch is hit high and foul down the right field side, way up and over the roof. Killebrew, two-run homer in the top of the eighth, puts the Twins down front 5-4. A knuckleball outside by Al Worthington. 1-1 the count to Blanchard. Blanchard batting at 274. Six doubles, no triples, one home run, eight RBI. Hasn't played too much. The 1-1 pitch to John is hit foul again down the right field side. Hit on the fifth, that's right. Well, they had it up there. A couple of people just hung over the edge of that upper deck and caught the ball, and it just trickled through their fingers. Worthington delivers to Blanchard. Knuckleball, swung and missed. The ball gets by the catcher. Blanchard will make it to first base. Not even close. That ball got completely past Earl Batty. And Johnny Blanchard is on at first base on a strikeout and a wild pitch. Well, there's a big break for the Yankees here in the bottom of the eighth inning. They get the front man at first, and there goes Hal Renneth in the run for Johnny Blanchard. That knuckleball exploded. Batty never got a glove to it. The ball just went by him like he wasn't standing there. So Al Worthington gets credit for the strikeout, but gets nobody out. Now he's still in. Renneth running for Blanchard at first base. Twins looking for the bunt. Worthington delivers outside. A throw to first. Almost had Renneth diving back. Whew. Hey, I want to tell you, that was close. Boy, that was a sneaky attempt by the second baseman, Jim Snyder, and a good play, really. They almost had Al Renneth. Now to pitch to Lynn, just bunted twice, and it's foul. That ball hit the plate, bounced up, and hit Lynn's bat, and went out about 2 feet in clear territory. So it's 1-1. Of course, if it was a deliberate effort on Lynn's part, he would now be out. But under the circumstances, he had no control over the fact that the ball bounced off the plate so quickly and hit his bat again. All right, Al Worthington. Big right-hander. Al Renneth at first base. Nobody out. A 1-1 count. Lynn squares this time. A good one. Batty is out. Worthington throws. Batty was going to make the play, and then he gave up. And Worthington just rather casually reached down and picked it up and threw it way high to the second baseman, Jim Snyder. And Lynn was across. So the charging an error to Al Worthington. And the Yankees now have runners at first and second and nobody down. And the batter will be Bobby Richardson. That also goes as a sacrifice for Phil Lynch. He gets credit for the sacrifice. The error is charged to the pitcher. How do you like that? A strikeout. They got nobody out. Now here's an error. They've got men at first and second. And nobody out. Bottom of the eighth inning. Twins leading the Yankees 5-4. Bobby squares and takes a strike on the outside corner. Rollins holding his ground at third in case Richardson should run that way. Don Mincher charging all the way. Al ran up at second. Phil Lynch at first. Nobody out. And we got things moving. Worthington sets the pitch to Bobby. Squares and takes his bat away just in time as the ball breaks outside. 1-1.
Heading for the mound.
second strikeout for Worthington. Don Mincher, Earl Batty, Sam Mealy, and Al Worthington all clustered around the mound. It's a 5-4 game, two outs, last of the eighth. Renneth at third, Lins at second. Coming to the plate, Mickey Mantle. And first base is open. So let's see how manager Sam Mealy handles this one. Following Mantle is Elston Howard. Mantle is 2-for-4, doubled and single his first two at bats. Well, tomorrow afternoon, as we told you, game time 1:30, a single game. And then into the All-Star break as Mantle comes to the plate. The All-Star game on July the 7th at Shea Stadium. Tuesday night, Wednesday afternoon the 15th, and suburban night July the 16th, the Baltimore Orioles are in town as they're going to pitch to Mantle. The first pitch is inside, ball one to Mickey. They're going to try to crowd him. Versalli's playing very deep at short, almost behind the bag. Now he takes a few steps to the left. Renneth at third, Lins at second. The one ball pitch to Mickey is hit high here. That ball is on its way for a three-run homer.
Home run homer.
Snyder takes a strike right in there. 1-1 the count. Johnny Gorel in the on deck circle. He'll be batting for the pitcher, Al Worthington. Mickelson, the 1-1 pitch is inside. Two balls, one strike. Harmon Killebrew put the Twins ahead in the top of the eighth, and Mickey Mantle put the Yankees back in front in the bottom of the eighth. Some timely hitting by two of the finest home run hitters in the business. Okay, Mickelson, the pitch to Snyder is high. 3-1 the count. Three balls, one strike. So, Pete Mickelson falling behind on the first batter. Jimmy Snyder. Snyder fouled to the catcher, single to left. Pops the third. We'll try to throw some scores your way as we go along. Mickelson, the 3-1 pitch. Outside, ball four, and he lost him. Mickelson walked his first batter. All right, let's take a look at the American League as Johnny Gorel comes on for Al Worthington. Boston 10, the Los Angeles Angels 2 after six innings. Thomas with a bases full homer in that game for the Red Sox. Mantilla homered, a Singleton in the sixth for the Sox. Washington 3, Detroit 2 after 4.5. The White Sox 1, the Indians nothing after 4.5. All the other games will be at night, except for one in the National League. The Phillies and the Giants not yet underway. As Gorel takes inside, ball one. Phillies and the Giants playing at San Francisco this afternoon. They'll be running against Stanford. No scores yet. And now Elston Howard is out to talk to Pete Mickelson. Leadoff batter here in the ninth inning, Jimmy Snyder, the second baseman, started things with a walk. Johnny Gorel batting for the pitcher, Al Worthington. A one ball count to Gorel. Yankees leading 7-5. Mickelson sets the pitch to Gorel. Strike right in there, 1-1. Gorel batting at 181. 13 hits in 72 at bats. Mickelson set again. Sets the runner. The pitch is fouled off into the upper deck. And the count is one ball, two strikes. Yanks lead, 7-5. Top of the ninth inning. Boy, what an exciting game this has been. The lead changed hands twice in the eighth inning. Yanks had a 4-1 lead. And the Twins got a run on the fourth and the fifth to make it 4-3, and then two in the eighth to go ahead 5-4, and then the Yankees came back with three in the eighth to make it 7-5. And right now, the Twins, with nobody out, have a runner at first and a 1-2 count to pinch hitter Johnny Gorel. Mickelson delivers a ground ball, lands to third, bobbles it, throws to second, in time to get one. Lynn trying to get the good hop. Backed up a moment and did knock the ball down and recovered very quickly in time to force Snyder at second base. Bobby almost got clobbered on that as Snyder was down there and, of course, trying to take the thrower out to knock off the double play. All right, Zolo Versalli comes on with one away. Johnny Gorel now at first base. Ninth inning. Yankees leading 7-5 as Mickelson delivers. There's a ground ball foul toward the Twins dugout and into the dugout. Well, the low overcast that we had through most of the day is starting to lift, and we have a high overcast now. Much brighter here at the stadium than it was at game time. All right, the one strike pitch to Versalli. The ground ball is short. Boyle coming in quickly. No chance to go to second. It gets Versalli to first. And we have two outs.
Good play by Boyer. He gave up trying to go to second as he was coming in fast on the ball and caught it about the edge of the infield grass. And the sun comes out here for the first time today. So we may have time called if Lopez in left field apparently wants his sunglasses. And there goes the ball boy. Tony running out there. Young Tony Florio going out to give Boyer his glasses and Lopez his. You can't help but admire the way that Boyer has been playing shortstop after almost a 4 or 5 year absence. He has done a whale of a job out there. Made all the plays. All right. Rich Rollins. Struck out, single to left, fly to right, bounce to short. 1 for 4. Yankees leading 7-5. 2 down. Mickelson sets. Checks the runner. Delivers. Swung on a miss. Strike one. Johnny Gaul at second base. Getting the sign from Howard. This ball game belongs to Bounce. Should Mickelson hold the lead?
There's a slow grounder towards third. Lynn's in front of Boyer up with a slip to Moore in time, and the ball game is over. A tough play by Lynn ending this ball game. For the Twins in the ninth. No runs, no hits, no Yankee errors. One man left. And the final score of this ball game, the Yankees 7, Minnesota 5, and I'll be back in a minute with the totals and the highlights.
Waves dropping sand grain by grain on the shore create an endless beach. But microscopic bits of dirt building up bit by bit can leave harmful deposits around the throttle plate of your car's carburetor. Some gasolines can leave these deposits. When that happens, the result can be rough idling, stalling, and wasted gasoline. You can avoid this source of engine trouble easily by choosing the gasoline that's guaranteed to keep your carburetor clean. Atlantic Imperial, it can actually clean away the dirt other gasolines deposit. Atlantic guarantees Imperial will clean your carburetor and keep it clean. Register with your Atlantic dealer. After you've used 100 gallons of Atlantic Imperial gasoline, your carburetor will be cleaned, or Atlantic will pay to have it cleaned, according to a liberal payment schedule. Use Atlantic Imperial, the clean carburetor gasoline.
Okay, a quick recap here of this ball game. The Yankees got 2 runs in the first inning after Minnesota scored a single run, and it stayed that way. The Yankees 2, the Twins 1. To the last of the third when the Yankees came up with 2 more on Pepitone's 2-run homer. It was then 4-1 in the fourth inning. Mincher homered for the Twins to make it 4-2. Fifth inning, it was Oliva hitting a home run to make it 4-3, that home run inside the park. And then in the eighth inning, the Twins went out in front 5-4 on Harmon Killebrew's 2-run blast. But in the bottom of the eighth, after Johnny Blanchard struck out on a knuckleball and was not held by Earl Batty, allowing Blanchard to get to first safely, Lynn bunted, and the pitcher, Al Worthington, threw wide at first base and high, putting runners at first and second and nobody out. Worthington was charged with the error. Richardson then sacrificed them to second and third. Lopez struck out. Mantle, with 2 down, unloaded a shot into the upper deck. And I mean a shot to win the ball game for the Yankees 7-5. And that's the way it ends. That was home run number 17 for Mickey Mantle. Oliva hit his 18th. Killebrew his 29th. And Mincher his 11th. So the Yankees won the first contest here by a score of 7-5. It'll be Al Downing and Camilo Pasquale in the second game. For the Yankees, 7 runs on 12 hits. The Twins, 5 runs on 8 hits.
This is...